Okay, you've got somebody. You don't know who this is, maybe. This is the family Vladimir Ilyich Ulyanov. Vladimir Lenin. This is the bastard's face. So this is the revolutionary that was instigated the Russian Revolution, but he was paid by the Pharaohs in Switzerland. And always contacts with Switzerland, the Pharaoh. He was financed from Switzerland. He came from Switzerland shortly before the revolution, and he was, as you can see, quite an aristocratic family. And this is his bastard's father. And look at this hand here. This is the Freemason Napoleonic Pharaonic indication of the second and third and fourth son that got together in the Freemasonry, in the Templars. The Freemasonry came from the Templars, and the Templars are the third and the second and the third and the fourth sons of Pharaoh, who also wanted to rule. And then they went into the convents and everything, and they took over the religion, but they infiltrated as Templars, and they used that power base to work toward a new world order, to overthrow the first son of the Pharaoh. But let there be no mistake, the first and the second and the third and the fourth son, all are Pharaohs. They're all bloody assholes. They are all killing idiots. They love sacrificing us as pawns. They themselves stay out of everything with their money in Switzerland, and they go on holiday, or they go to Switzerland, and they let us fight, and then they say Switzerland is neutral, and then Switzerland finance both parties. So this is Mr. Lenin's family, all kind of aristocratic, you see, all very, very posh and very expensive clothes. And this guy here, Freemason, okay? Lenin was posthumous subject of persuasive personality cult, because the so-called Soviets, the commies, they say, we're not into God, and the religion is opium of the people, but they elevate these kind of thugs as their gods, so they just worship these kind of thugs. And they are also religious kind of cultist, sectist, satanic cult. It is not, and they laugh about other religions, but they are themselves are bloody cult, brainwashed bloody cult, and they're bloody pharaohs, just like all the other aristocrats. They are all bloody pharaohs, I'm telling you. So, went to socialist discussion circle. Lenin fully embraced Marxism and produces a Russian language translation of Marx from Frederick Engels in 1848, a political pamphlet, the Communist Manifesto. In May, Maria, who retained society influence as a widow of a nobleman. You see, they're all part of the same circles. Lenin remained in power for 7 years. 1893, Lenin moved to St. Petersburg, and then assisted in the revolution. Called itself Social Democrats after the Marxist Social Democratic Party of Germany. And he was married with Nanzela Krupskaya, who was also a Russian Bolshevik revolutionary. Financed by his mother, they stayed in a Swiss house bar before traveling to Berlin. He proceeded to Paris to meet Marx's son, Paul Lefebvre, and to research the Paris Commune. which he has considered early type of proletarian government financed by his mother, he stayed in a Swiss health spa before traveling to Berlin, where he studied for 6 weeks dance bibliothèque and the Marxist activist Leib Knecht. Returning to Russia with a stash of illegal publications, he traveled various cities distributing lectures. So you see, he stayed in Switzerland, so called, because he was Russian Marxist. Lenin hoped to cement connections between the social democrats of emancipation of labor, a group of Russian Marxist immigrants based in Switzerland. He visited the country to meet up the group members of Plekhanov and Pavel Axelrod. He proceeded to Paris to meet Marx's son. So, you see the contact with Switzerland, with pharaohs, aristocrats. They are all hidden in so-called other organizations with another mask. So it's also got contacts with Switzerland. You see it again. Switzerland is again the common denominator of all the things that are going on, especially in the last century, the 20th century, there's a lot of common denominator with the troubles in the 20th century with Switzerland. Okay, so that's Bloody Meyer, and that's his wife. This is the wife of Lenin, and her name is Nadia Krupskaya, and she was born in the upper class family. Her father comes at the Nikonovich Krupski, military officer, nobleman. And again you see the second and third sons of Pharaoh, who are fighting for power, so they are impoverished nobility. And they are still fighting for power, and both of them, the first son and the second and the third, and so on, son, all pharaohs fighting for the power, and they use us as pawns. So this is what's going on for 10 centuries or millennia already. Here constant Russian military officer, nobleman of Russian Empire, who had been orphaned in 1847 at the age of 9. So a lot of also very similar kind of family situation is also there's a fatherless boy with his mother. So like the goddess of Isis, also the pharaoh Isis with Orisis and Horus. It's all the same kind of thing. So Macron is also so that kind of little sneaky bastard. So, with his wife, with his older wife, so with the son and her and his mother, without the father, so it's a kind of a matriarchal, pharaonic Isis worship situation. And here, Krupskaya's mother was a daughter of landless Russian nobles. So landless is also again. Impoverished nobility, the second and third sons of Pharaoh, who think they are being cheated out of their inheritance. But of course, both of them, the first son also, has no right to their inheritance. Every time they cheat and they murder and they wage wars and they use us as pawns, so they have totally. If they ever had one, they totally thrown away their right to us. The aristocracy does not have a right to any of us. They are thugs. They are evil thugs. That's the problem. So, Elvita's parents died when she was young, and she was enrolled in Bethesda courses, a form of education, available to a woman. But you see, again, here's a nobility, and also Lenin's wife is also a nobility. So, having parents who were well educated of aristocratic descent. So, now you can see the commies are just another way of saying it is a there's another way of being a king. It's just commies, and they act as if they're for the working people, but they are actually just kings in disguise. Okay, do you understand now? Or is it going to get into your head now? In any case, that's her, that's his wife. This is his eldest brother, Alexander. He was also a revolutionary, but also, you see, it's also an aristocrat with a very funny face, like a pharaoh. You see this whole kind of funny face. This is his little ugly little sister, and she, on the night of 1st of March 1901, she was arrested and imprisoned in solitary confinement in Tangaskana prison. After a 7-month sentence, she was deported to Masamara a third time, was arrested in January 1904, released on bail in June of the same year, after which she left for Switzerland, again Switzerland. This is also the second, third son of Pharaoh, also fighting against the Tsar. So they're all worthless Tsars. They're all Tsarkographs. So they're all Tsars, Pharaoh, Caesar. It's also Pharaoh. Okay? There's another one. This is also a brother, also called some kind of revolutionary. This is his sister. And this is Lenin himself. Okay, look at that face. Now, would you say, oh, is that Lenin? Or is this Lenin? Or is this Lenin? Is this a portrait of Lenin? Or is it not? No, it is Charles Manson. You can see, it looks exactly like the same face. What the hell is going on here? It looks like a clone of Mr. Lenin. I don't know. Wouldn't you think like that? Yeah, look at this swastika, look at this guy, and this is a commie, and this is a Nazi, and I bet they all got pharaonic blood in them. They're all fucking pharaohs.